have to record this one, man. This is crazy. Hey, baby, listen. I took you to Applebee's, just get something to eat, and that's it. That's all we gotta do.
You're recording me? I don't like Applebee's.
I don't want you, but I know it's our third date. I wanted to get something to eat because we don't gotta. This is Applebee's. I can't pay Friday.
No, do I look like an Applebee's type person?
I'm not saying you look like Applebee's. No. I'm just saying, let's go to Applebee's right here and let's go get something to eat.
No.
And then Friday, we be good Friday.
Friday, we can go to Fridays?
We be good Friday to go to get something else to eat. It's better, but right
why not
now.
Wait till Friday.
I want to take y'all something to eat now. I want to take y'all now.
Okay, well, you can go eat.
Come on, let's go.
No, I don't want to go.
Let's go. You
enjoy your 2 for $20. I'm not a 2 for $20 type of girl. Do you see me?
I know, but I'm saying. I know, but I'm not saying you don't know. I'm just saying, let's go to Applebee's.
No.
We're already here.
No. I want some Ocean Prime, some Papa Dough's.
Oh, then we'll wait till another day. I don't got the.
Okay, so what you have to get?
I'm about to say this right now. Papa Dough's is trash. I think Red Lobster better. This might break the internet. I'm picking Red Lobster over Papa Do's. That's just trash.
Stressful.
Don't want to take you out to eat, like, man. This is hard,
like,
man.
No, you have
come on, you ready? Like, now you're standing up. Now let's go.
I don't want to go. I'm going to watch you go. And you tell me how it was.
Oh, see, Friday. We got to do it Friday then.
I am,
man. I was going to say, just get something to eat.
I'm 1,000% sure this is a skit. But let's not skip over the fact that it's women out here that really feel like that. It's women out here that really feel as though going to Applebee's is disrespectful. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. Back in the days, Applebee's was the shit. I used to take my girlfriend to Applebee's. We used to go on dates to Applebee's. They had a little specials or whatever. And shoot, we're married now. Sometimes you gotta get it out the mud, yo. I just don't be understanding spending a whole bunch of money on people that you barely know. Thank God I'm married. I would have such a hard time dating right now. I would be on everybody's TikTok getting exposed. Because back in them days, I had no car. I was taking people on dates to Waffle House, Applebee's, Chick-fil-A. I went on a date to Chick-fil-A. And I slept on an air mattress. But I was clapping a lot of cheeks on them air mattresses. I know, in 2024, yeah, somebody would have been exposed to my ass.
Don't choke.
This is nice.
That's don't nice. What? Oh, wait. Ha, 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 ha. Ho, wait. Hold on. It's a lot of things going on. First off, what the fuck was that? What hair did he move out of his hair? I'm sorry. And did this man tell him not to choke?
Don't choke.
Oh, okay.
Don't choke.
This is nice.
That's nice.
You said what?
Don't choke.
Oh, choke. Oh, okay. No, you said choke.
Boy. I'm sorry. This funny as hell. He's ready to go. What the fuck held his neck? Stop it. I don't care whether you straight or gay. That is hilarious. He is ready to go. Man's wet. That boy moist. That boy was moist.
I didn't want to be the person to say this, but ladies, if a dude been pursuing you for years or a long ass time, just go, don't talk to him. Especially if he's been pursuing you and you've been curving him, don't talk to him. Because the remix is going to be diabolical. You may not.
Hey, boy, I knew that's where he was going. That revenge is going to be so sweet, baby girl. That revenge is going to be so sweet because my boy is just counting them days. He going to remember all the hardships you put him through. All the loops he had to jump just to get to you. For you to play hard to get. All the insults. he had to go through. Go ahead, brother. I'm sorry.
Cover from me. Like, dudes who be chasing y'all for the longest and y'all diss them or y'all don't pay them no mind, y'all don't give them no chance, they are leveling up. Like, that diabolical switch up is going to be crazy. Facts. You're going to go in there thinking like, oh, I think because they wanted me for a long time, they're going to really come in there and be serious and genuine with me. No. They finna humble you in the worst way possible. Mm-hmm. They going to humble you so bad, you legit may not recover. You may resort to some type of substance. I'm not going to lie to you. Like, because they're plotting on you. Like, oh, you think you are there? Yeah, don't worry about it. And then, boom. Well, how could he treat me like that? He wanted me first. Yeah, that was the point. And you didn't want him when he wanted you, so now he got to show you you're not all that.
Facts.
I'm telling y'all not going to listen to me, though.
Ain't nothing worse than when you feeling a chick and she not feeling you, and she let you know she's not feeling you. To be quite honest with you, right? Most men, and I feel as though this is the manliest thing you can do. If she's not feeling you, move on. I think going out your way for a chick that's constantly showing you that there's no light at the end of a tunnel, that is the most simperoni pizza thing you can do. A lot of dudes that be in the friend zone, we consider them the good guys. Mr. Romantic. Mr. Go Above and Beyond. Crazy thing is, the dudes that be getting the cheeks is the ones that don't do that type of thing, that don't go over and beyond. That is the total opposite from Mr. Romantic. So now once Mr. Romantic starts showing signs of Mr. Ain't, that's when you start coming around. Y'all be turning these dudes into these villains. You wonder why he acting like the way he acting after you finally give him a chance. I want to thank y'all for 100K. Now, if you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. But you know what? Subscribing isn't the only important thing. I want you to hit that notification bell.
So there's a few things that I don't do as a married woman. Number one, I do not cook for my husband. I only cook for my children. My husband will be making his own breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Number two, I do not help him pay any bills.
Wait, bro. Who is paying for the food that you're cooking? There is no way. I'm throwing that out there right now. There is no way. I go to work a 12-hour shift and come back home. You're not even going to put some food on the table for me?
Well, if he is short on the rent, on utilities, or anything like that, it is not my problem. I will not be helping him out. His job is to provide for his family, so I am not financially contributing to any of the bills. Number three, I do not do his laundry. I have my own laundry and my children's laundry to do, so he could do his own. I won't help him put it away. I won't help him fold anything. Like, that's his responsibility. Number four, he is responsible for replacing any of his essentials, like soap, shampoo, anything like that. He needs to go buy it himself. Even if I'm at the store, I will not be replacing it for him. If he needs new underwear, new socks, or anything like that, that's for him to do. I'm not going to do it for him. I'm not going to enable a perfectly grown-ass adult, because then they get used to that shit, so no.
You see how contradictory that is? He has basically enabled you by paying all the bills. You not even... I hate people that take advantage of other people. Whether it's your wife, your mother, your brother, your sister, your cousin, she's taking advantage. You guys are married. You don't cook for him. You don't clean for him. You don't do his laundry. If he falls on hard times, you're not going to help him. What the fuck is your purpose as a wife? As upset as I can be at you, I am just as upset at him. How can you allow somebody to get that comfortable at being so disrespectful? Sometimes I really hate the internet. The fact that you're doing that ish and you're so proud of it that you're coming on the internet and telling the rest of the world?
Hey, this is the type of people you should and shouldn't fight. Let's talk about the biometrics. As a man, you want to fight another man between a height of 6'2 to 5'7. If you're taller than 6'2 and 250 pounds, you're going to need a gun. That's a big-ass man. That is a middle linebacker. He's 5'6 and shorter. He going to have a gun. Chihuahuas don't fight. They pew-pew.
Oh, nah, right, gangster.
As far as the age goes.
Hey, hold on, folks. Hold on, boy. I'm 5'6". I fall into that. I ain't no goddamn chihuahua, nigga. What?
I'm gonna fight somebody over the age of 25, but under the age of 45. 45 and older, that's them old lions. They finna shoot you.
Facts.
He done been through his wars.
Facts.
He got kids.
Facts.
Assets. People depending on him. He not finna go down today for your goofy ass.
Facts.
And then 25 and under, that's them young cats. They not finna fight you neither.
Facts.
He finna shoot you because he trying to put some pelts on his wall. You feel me? Young trapper scammer. You want to fight somebody between the age of about 26 to 44, they might give you a fair one. You might. Maybe.
The crazy thing is, everything he said is so accurate. Them boys 25 and younger, not fighting you. Them old heads 45 and up, not fighting you. Where I play ball at, when these folks get to arguing, you know who going to the car first. You know what age bracket is going to the car and what age bracket is ready to throw hands. You know what? No, this shit ain't 100% accurate. Let's double back. Because dudes that's 5'6 and under usually have shit to prove, and they got them goddamn hands, my boy. As somebody who has had a few fights in my lifetime, I'd rather fight people taller than me. Because I know for sure if they my height or shorter, it's tend to be difficult.
What's your type?
I ain't gonna lie, I like them dark skins.
Oh my god! Wow!
Que diablo, dark skins.
Eso tigre hacen que te men seem. You gotta pee on yourself, respectfully. Like,
they got that schlongy.
The schlongy. They got the affection.
What?
They gotta eat your feet, your toes, your neck, your ears. It's
damn.
Over after that. You don't want nothing else.
Yet. It wasn't tight.
I ain't gonna lie.
Them Hispanic girls, they starting a war now. That dark skin. It's not going to be allowed to step foot in DR and Puerto Rico. You know what I realized, too? It's regular for, like, a Dominican or Puerto Rican. Like, pretty regular for them to mess with black dudes. I want to word this the right way so it don't come out disrespectful. I be feeling as though a lot of Mexican women be wanting to mess with black dudes, but they don't want to be judged by their family. This the video I was talking about. Look at her. Look at her.
Mackenzie, Diana, South America. Miss, your husband is dying behind you. You over there doing the life insurance two-step. You need to go and get one of these for your husband. He crashing. He ain't gonna make it. Go and call the nurse and the doctor. No, you need to get one of these. Why you over there dancing? The man dying behind you, miss. Gotta do everything for the internet. I hate this planet, bro.
This the video I was talking about. I don't know if y'all remember when I was talking about older women be on the internet just doing young girl shit. This is one of the videos I was talking about. Her husband back there looked like he 1 foot in, 1 foot out. And she on the internet showing cheeks. Then she looked like she damn near 60. I ain't gonna lie though. She looked pretty good for her age. Unless, you know, filtration going on. I'm gonna say something that might sound fucked up. But she probably advertising for when he get up out of here.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, y'all done lost y'all damn mind. A hotel worker found $650,000 under a bed, under one of the hotel beds, like in the box spring or whatever, found $650,000 and turned it into the police. I know you telling a damn
bro,
lie.
Get the
ain't no way. It couldn't have been me. I can promise you that now. I love the Lord just like anybody else. I got integrity, but I ain't stupid. I'm working at a hotel cleaning up behind people. You know what I'm saying? Folks getting sick, people having all type of nasty, freaky intercourse all on the hotel bed, and you cleaning up after the people coming to the hotel, getting drunk, throwing up all over stuff. They bringing babies in here, the baby done doo-doo all on the sheets, all type of stuff, and you find $650,000 under the day, and you
yeah.
Tell who?
Yeah.
You crazy.
That'll be my last day. That'll be my last day coming to work. I'm letting you know right now, that'll be my last day, dog. There is no way. What you think the police finna do with that money? Huh? I've told this story before. Y'all know I love to tell stories. I'm gonna tell y'all this. This how I'm gonna end the video, right? When I was in college, me and my boy was downstairs in the lounge area. We was like shooting pool or something like that. We decided to go back to his room. We stepped on the elevator, and in the elevator was a big bag full of pre-bagged marijuana. It was all dime bags. We picked that up, went to his room, split that motherfucker in half. I got about 30, he got about 30, or something to that effect. And for a week and a half, I was on campus feeling like Ghost from Power. I was out there like paid in full. When I say I was going crazy, I was going crazy. I'm talking about I had specials, 2 for 10s, 3 for 15. And the news started spreading like wildfire. Like RJ in room 721, he got the gas. Now, what I'm going to say about that, the more new faces that started coming to my door, I started becoming more paranoid. So it'll be all times of the night, just random people just come knocking on my door. That shit started feeling weird. The first couple of days, it was people I knew. Eventually, it started being people that I did not know. People that I wouldn't even trust to tell that, yo, I got that gas. Started coming to my door. So that's really why I started doing the specials too. But the specials made it worse. I was doing the specials to get rid of it fast, as fast as I can. And then what made it even more crazy was when my man was like, bro, I can't even sell all this shit, bro. Can't you just hear it, bro? I don't even care about it like that. So now I got my half that I took from it, and then he gave me the rest of his half.